When it comes to work-life balance, the ratios and discussions are all in the wrong place. One can hardly be expected, with their most determined of mind, to speak the words they feel staring down the misery of instant dismissal. Besides, it's a conversation seldom presented in equal footing. If you approach a prisoner whilst incarcerated and ask, "Do you think you should spend less time within the confines of this facility, or do you feel your fullest human potential is best found outside the endless routine these walls offer?" Well, it'd be a foolish bet for anyone but the most addicted of gamblers. Therefore, it is true that the conversation itself is a falsity. A bad quote on a kitchen refit by a fat man scratching his balls and dropping cigarette butts in a mugs of half full tea. Of course, consideration should be put forward at the outset. If one enjoys work, is it work or merely insanity? Stockholm Syndrome. Hard to say if you're an artist, fighter pilot, porn star or professional golfer. To be fair, the medical profession has a decent array of possibilities given an employee's understanding of what makes them truly happy. Imagine saving a man's life. Imagine a man who's rolled into the ward dead from drink and you bring him back with a kiss of life. A kiss he returns of kebab vomit. You get some in your mouth. Time's a cruel metric. Time is a cruel mistress, compares the most ejaculate of experience in a physical sense to that of a metaphysical sense. Both the joy of life and the horror of life mere seconds apart. Ha 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 ha!